I hope you all are doing extremely well. So today I have quite a bit of stuff to show you. I have all kinds of different things out. And everything I have today is from my art supplies stuff. So I have different brushes, different paints, different writing tools. New marker set that I got. In this case comes with 30 Sharpie markers. Thing about this is it comes with 6 bonus coloring pages. And on the bottom here, it shows all the different markers. So as you can see here, it says fade and water resistant ink. Okay. And in this first row, it has black, aqua, and lilac. The next line, you have brown, lime, purple, yellow, and argyle green, I believe it says. This next column here, you have slate gray, orange, and banana clip yellow. Okay, this next one here, you have sky. And in this last row here, you have turquoise, berry, and valley girl violet. ahead and try to open this. You can see all the different colors that I got. And underneath, there are some 6 pages of coloring pages. So, now that I have this open, I'm going to actually leave them how they are in there because they each have their own little place. So for now I'm gonna keep them all in here, but I would love to do a video soon coloring one of those pages. So alright, this next thing that I'm gonna show you is my watercolor palette, and this is the one that I've been using this year. I actually have another one of these, but it's completely out, pretty much, all the way out of paint. And I used this a lot last year, actually, to do paintings and stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and open this up. Maybe. Okay. Like raindrops. I'm gonna go ahead and move on and show you these. I got 4 different tubes of acrylic paint. These are the 4 tubes that I got. first one. This is titanium white. This next one is aqua. This one is Mars Black. And this last one here is primary yellow. Going to do is I am going to show you each one of those here on paper. Alright, so we're going to start with this one. Get a good look at the tip of that and just see all the different colors. Okay, so let's do it this way. see a little bit better. So that is that one. This next one we're gonna try is this blue, a multicolored blue, and it looks like some greens and purples maybe in there. Okay. And if you don't notice, I'm kind of turning the pencil as I'm going. And that is giving it the different colors. You can see different shades of blue. Some are darker blues, some are lighter, and then you can also see some green. Certain areas. This next one we're gonna try. It's more of a pink purple. It got some blue in there too. So. And so then you just turn it and you kind of want to change the shade. So right now I'm at a blue, now I'm going into a darker blue, and if I turn it just a tiny bit, it starts giving you more of a purple look and pink. Okay, this next one looks like it's going to has yellows and orange and pinks and reds. This one didn't show up too good, but it's still really pretty. Okay, this next one. It's green. Also, it looks like it has some yellows and stuff. Okay, next we got this one, and it has black, white, and gray. So we're gonna see what this one does. And now is when I'm turning it a little bit. This one all kinds of different speckles of colors. I see red, yellow, blue. So yeah. Next, real quick, I'm just going to show you my little gel pens. So, I don't know if I've said this before on another video or not, but I keep all my pens in this little raggedy Ann and Andy cup. Also, I got some highlighters and different markers. This next thing that's kind of cool, it's a little purse style thing, and it dispenses post-its. So this actually reminds me of Romeo and Michelle, if you've seen the movie. This sound over here for tapping. So I'm gonna get a little bit closer. And these are all brand new. I got these in a kit with a bunch of different art supplies. So, I've still never have used these yet. So, and these are some beautiful brushes. They have a really, really beautiful blue tip here at the end. And then here they have a rubber grip for when you are holding it down. And you might remember getting these if your school had book fairs or anything like that. They usually had some fun pens like this with all kinds of different colors on the end. Sandy's not on there. Okay. But anyways. So, this next thing. Actually, I have three of them to show you. I have a pink pair, a red pair, and a blue pair. Thank you. I'm going to show you what it looks like if you've never actually got to cut with these before. So, you can kind of see how it made a bit of a squiggly look to the paper. When I was younger and I would make people cards or anything, I would take these scissors and I would just go on the outline of the whole entire paper or card or whatever. And it would just kind of give it a special look. Here's one of those little tiny miniature highlighters. So. Just my little pouch of pencils, and I got some charcoal pencils down at the end. And then just some colorful pencils. Let's just spend a few minutes specifically on the back. things that I really like about these two boxes are they both come with their own little handle right here. So they're like their own little artist's briefcase type thing. It's really cute. It's also really handy if you're out and about, like say you are at the park and you're wanting to do some art. This is nice because you can actually set your canvas here or your paper, whatever you're drawing on. You can set it here and you'll actually have a hardback surface. Slowly transition into some scratching sounds. Okay. So this is what it looks like inside. And as you can see, it has all kinds of different I'm actually going to do a flip through of this at the end of today's video. Page turning is one of my favorite triggers, so I'm going to come back to this a little bit later. Okay, so this box mainly holds a lot of my stickers and I'm just going to hold some up so that you can see. Got some Monster High stickers. These are those jelly things that you're able to stick on your window for seasonal. These are some Valentine's Day Star Wars stickers. I believe these came in one of those Valentine's Day to you from me cards, Valentine's cards. So. A nice sound. These are just some puffy stickers of different little hearts and stuff. Okay, let's see here. I've used most of them, just, you know, decorating little cute things and stuff. I actually used these to decorate my mannequin headstand. So if you've ever been to school for cosmetology, and you've had to decorate some of your merchandise. I used a lot of stickers and bedazzles and fabric. So. Not this muffin. This cupcake is just stuck on that somehow. Back there, yeah. You got some cupcakes and some ice cream cones. You got a donut. There's a chocolate covered cherry right there. zoo animal stickers. They got some really cute ones. There's some alligators. There's a lion and a couple bears. Some giraffes. The elephant is super cute. The hippo is super cute. The monkey is super cute. All they're really cute. Okay, so I have just a few more stickers in here. Here's just a couple random stickers. Okay. Got these stickers. These are brand new. I've never used these yet. Just some artistic. And this is the last thing in this box. Now I still have one more box full of stuff to show you. And what this is just full of different sleeves of paper for doing soft sound. Okay. So, I'm gonna go ahead and start putting everything back in this box. That way we can keep the only thing that I kept out is actually this book here. So, and again, I'm gonna come back to this. So, okay, so this is the next box full of stuff. For oil painting, and I've still never used these yet. I've actually never done oil painting in my life, so that'll be fun to try out with you guys. Okay, These are different colorful chunks. So, I want to do something with these. I definitely want to do a really awesome drawing with these. I have a couple ideas in mind. So, we're going to see. This is the last thing in this box here. Okay. Yeah. So, I have more of these. These are not all together, sadly. These are my oil pastels. And I don't know why I have random chalks. In here. I need to organize my art stuff a little bit. Okay. Sort of visually pleasing to me. Just watching. So, we're going to go ahead and put the rest of the stuff back into this box. have just a few more things to kind of quickly show you before I go ahead and start showing you this book. So I picked this item up about a week ago when I was shopping at Goodwill, and I saw it, and it was 50 cents, by the way. And it is a full sketchbook of blank black pages. Actually has two tags on one side. So this is actually the front part of the book. This is such a beautiful cover. Feel all the individual feathers. That's so cool. That is so awesome. I love this so much. I love this. if I had a video of like the top favorite items that make the coolest sounds, this would be the video. And I love the sounds it makes when it opens too. And closing of the book itself. Pretty neat, if I don't say so myself. Okay. Alright, really quickly I'm gonna show you just a few of my favorite pieces of watercolor art that I've done. And I did a full video flipping through this. Okay, so I'm not gonna show every single one, but I will show the few that I just adore completely. So these are the Three Canker Sisters from Ed, Edd n Eddy. If you've ever seen that show, it used to be on Cartoon Network. This one here is Viola Swamp, and I actually have the book and I do want to read that for a video. That was my favorite childhood book. Well, I think it was definitely one of my favorite childhood books. And as you can see, I did use the scribble technique for the hair. So I did some pen work for watercolor. I like to do. I did this picture. If you have watched the Powerpuff Girls, this is the gangrene. That little guy down there. I think that one was my favorite to draw. Oh my goodness, this one is super special. If you don't know who this is, oh my goodness, this is one of the cutest little characters ever. This is a very special drawing to me. Okay, so I'm actually gonna do a video in the future reading this poem. If you're familiar with this face, I'm going to go ahead and tell you the name of the character so that it's not going to be bugging you. This is Bumble Artie. Okay, and there was a short little episode, and it was a beautiful poem about this boy having a birthday party. Okay, and it is my favorite. I want to do a video just reading that poem, whispering it and stuff. So yeah, my dad watched that episode a lot when he was a little boy, and he showed it to me. And so yeah, I love that. Sweet Adeline, 9 times over 9. And you'll know what I mean when I do the video. Did this watercolor of Farizzo. Oh my gosh. I didn't finish bedazzling it yet. But this is Kristen Scow, if you've seen Last Man on Earth. This is Care Bear. I love that show. For some reason, I started watching it last year. That's my happy show these days. Like, it's just, it's great. If you haven't seen the show ever, one thing about this character is that she loves to bedazzle things. Like, everything. So, that's why I actually bedazzled her shirt with the stick. Yeah. So if Kristen Scow ever sees this, ever, just know you're awesome. I love you. I drew you. She's beautiful. Okay. So. I do have one of my watercolor drawings in a frame. So let me go grab that really quick because I want to include that in on this video too. Okay. I'll be right back. Okay. So I actually got this framed because it's one of my favorite pieces of art that I've ever done. And don't mind the ear. That was an accident. I plan on doing several. Different techniques and things. But yeah, this is my Steve Buscemi watercolor. I love this. Steve Buscemi, if you are watching this, I love your work. I love it. Now that I've showed you a few of my favorite pieces of my artwork, And that's just from one book. The rest of my sketchbooks, they're kind of just packed away and stuff like that. This big book full of pages. This is my favorite size of sketchbook, so I'm really excited to do drawings in this and make videos doing them. So, let's see. Now that I've showed you kind of an overall look at everything that I am going to be working with and showing on future videos, I want to go ahead and show you that book. And this book, this was actually sitting on a table next to me when I was painting this very large painting, okay? And I had my cup of water with the little paintbrushes sticking out of it, and I bumped the cup. Really wet, and you can still see the ripple. I was gonna throw this book away at the time because I didn't really use it. It was just kind of there. It came with a kit of all kinds of stuff. But once it dried, I kind of liked how the front of it looked. I mean, it's ruined. I mean, that's what I was thinking. This book is ruined, you know. But I held on to it. I didn't throw it away. I just let it dry. And so now, this is actually a book that I think makes beautiful, beautiful sounds because of the ripplage. Now, I'll show you. Now at the time when I had spilled the water, the paint water, on this book, I thought the words were going to be all mushed together and faded away. But they're perfectly readable, they're fine. All the paintings and drawings and little tips and things, they're perfect. Fine. So sometimes when something abrupt happens, you might think it's the end of the world or something, but sometimes things aren't that bad and it's okay. So actually, page turning is one of my favorites. I wanted to end this video today just with some nice soft page turning, okay? And this book actually has some really so if you're interested, I'd totally be down for doing a video just on this book, going more into detail. showing up close pictures because they have some really have airbrush machine, airbrush gun, airbrush paints, all that. So it's still in the package though, like it's never been out of the box, just because I've been waiting until I have enough room to actually use it. More towards the middle here, as we're getting closer to the very middle, the pages seem way less warped and things. So this page talks about framing. Temporary framing, permanent framing. Color theory for ink. This goes into explaining more about secondary colors, tertiary colors, intermediate colors, your primary colors, things like that. Direct mixing. Talks about turpentine and salt. Ooh, this page is cool. This goes into talking about cross hatching. And this is one of the several techniques that you most likely learn in your first year of art class, of any art class. So I would say definitely in your first year of practicing art, you would most likely learn several techniques. Cross hatching being one, you would learn hatching, you'd learn blending, you'd learn scribbles and stippling. So you'd learn different displays how to use them. This is pretty cool. This shows this first picture, and this is what they painted from that. So that would be a reference painting. The appropriate contrast, talking about dry brushing. There's a lot of definitions in here. Definitions and little tips and tricks of different techniques that you can practice. So, just little different pictures. And I can go in more into detail on a separate video if you would like. So just let me know if you enjoy this art book. Look at that beautiful picture. Wide open space. This page goes over different positions that you can hold your paintbrush in. You can hold it vertically if you would like. There is a position to where you hold it horizontally with your palm facing down. So let me show you. So this would be kind of what they're showing. I'll show you. Let's see, they got also the brush tilted, so that would be a vertical pose, really, with your hand. And then brush horizontal, palm up, so then that one would be where your actual palm is facing the sky. So, some really cute illustrations here. I would love to do a painting like that someday. I love the pastel colors. And actually, if you read about this picture, this was actually drawn at nighttime. So if you see more of the darker tones, dark blue and the purples and the browns and things, that was actually drawn in the dark. I'm sure the person could see what they were drawing, but still, the lighting was dark. So, and then this, you got this mouse with a gigantic ear. That is so cute. I love that. So, yeah, just showing different, let's see, mixed techniques for lines. So, yeah, this just goes to show everyone has their own specific way that they do things, way that they start and finish things. So if you're more of a, you know, you draw your straight lines, you like everything to be in its own spot, or then there's the artists that are just a little bit, you know, they just draw real jaggedy lines and kind of just sketches. Okay. Got a few, one more page. So this page goes into different mixed techniques. And And it just shows different paintings of this scenery, this boat about to sail away. And over here, you got a black and white version of the same drawing. So that's pretty neat. This goes into talking about different ink-based markers, different waxes that you can use, watercolor pencils. Wow, I've never used a watercolor pencil before. And then here on the back, it just goes into, you know, what series, because they have different series. So this is called inks and washes, and it looks like they have a red series, which is all about the artistic subjects. They have a blue series, which covers all about techniques. Their green series covers various subjects, and their yellow series covers history. I really hope that all of you enjoyed that. I plan on doing a lot of artwork in the future, so I'm excited to show you guys.